Sí, ho veieu bé?
Sí, sí, es veu bé, sí.
Vale, doncs començo. Hello, my name is Judit Boadella, and I'm going to explain to you this study that several of the members of the Institute of Aquatic Ecology performed some years ago, titled Natural versus Man-made Mediterranean Coastal Lagoons, Distinct Microbial Functioning Depending on Season. This lagoon focuses on a Mediterranean marsh, which are humid environments located in coastal areas, which usually have brackish or salty lagoons. This lagoon's hydrology depends a lot on the entrance of seawater during storms, in which are called flooding episodes. And in between those flooding episodes, there are long periods of time in which these lagoons tend to dry up because of evaporation, called confinement periods. So these lagoons follow which is called a flooding confinement regime. Also, their dynamic depends a lot on seasonality, meaning that with temperature, there are changes in their primary production, respiration, and also nutrient cycles. These marshes during last century suffered a lot from a high entropic pressure, but more recently, more importance has been given to these ecosystems for all the ecosystem services that they provide. So they have been more protected and some restoration practices have been done in order to conserve them. This is the case of La Platera, located in l'Estartit, in the northeast of the Iberian Peninsula. And we studied 6 permanent lagoons in there. We classified these lagoons into old lagoons and new lagoons. The old lagoons consisted of 2 natural lagoons and 1 lagoon that was created in 2002. And the new lagoons were 3 lagoons, all of them created in 2016. Since this study was performed during 2017, so 1 year after the creation of the new lagoons, our intention was to compare these new lagoons with the old ones to see how the restoration was doing. Our specific objectives were to determine if the microbial capacity to use organic matter was the same in new lagoons that old lagoons. In this case, expecting no differences between these lagoons because several flooding episodes have already occurred, so the lagoons were homogenized, and also microbial communities have a fast capacity to adapt to changes. Another objective that we had was to determine the effects of seasonality in the microbial functioning and to see if it affected differently the old than the new lagoons. In this case, we expected differences during confinement period because it's the period in which those lagoons are more isolated and probably the new ones would have a different behavior than the old ones. As I've said, we performed these samplings during 2017 and we did 4 samplings, 1 per season. In each of those samplings, we took samples of water to measure its physicochemistry and also some biological parameters. We mainly focused on the dissolved organic matter quality and also the extracellular enzyme activities and the functional diversity. We measured the dissolved organic matter quality through its optical properties, and we calculated some indexes that gives us some idea of the quality of that dissolved organic matter, meaning that we know if it was more or less aromatic or recalcitrant, and if its origin was more autochthonous of the lagoon or if it was more autochthonous, so it had more terrestrial inputs. We also measured the extracellular enzyme activities. In this case, we measured five of them: glucosidase breaks simple polysaccharides, chelicidase breaks hemicellulose, so plant originated material. Peptidase and phosphatase are related with the uptake of nitrogen and phosphorus. And phenoloxidase is related with the degradation of lignin. The functional diversity, we measured it through the biolog eco plates, which are plates that contain 31 different carbon substrates. And with the incubation of the lagoon water, we were able to determine if the community was able to use those carbon substrates or not. And with that data, we could measure some diversity indexes. In this case, this diversity is not calculated by the number of species, but it's calculated with the number of carbon substrates that this microbial community is able to use. So it's a functional measure of this diversity. If we look at the results of the physicochemical data, with this PCA, we see that the main differences happen between seasons. Here in the right, we have the squares and rounds, which are those samples from winter and spring. And in this case, all the lagoons are mixed. But in the rest of the graph, we see that there are differences between old and new lagoons. In the left, we see the black painted points, which belong to the old lagoons during summer and autumn. And in the right part, we see the white painted points that belong to the new lagoons during summer and autumn. In the middle of old and new lagoons, we see these gray points, which belong to the lagoon that was created in 2002. So there's kind of a gradient between natural lagoons, this lagoon created in 2002, and the new lagoons in the physicochemical data. If we see the dissolved organic matter quality, in this case, we only detected differences between old and new lagoons in January for the SUBA index, which gives us the idea that all lagoons had a more aromatic organic matter than new lagoons. The rest of the differences that were detected for the dissolved organic matter quality were only between seasons, in which January was different in all cases from the rest of the months. In this case, we see also that January had a more aromatic organic matter, and it also was more allotonous, and it was produced less recently than the other months, and it had a more input of terrestrial material. Checking the extracellular enzyme activities, we observed that glucosidase and chelicidase increase with time, and those were the main differences between months. And differences between old and new lagoons were only detected in July and October. In all of these cases, the old lagoons showed higher enzyme activities than the new lagoons. Looking to phosphatase and peptidase activities, the peptidase one tendency is the same, increasing with seasons and showing only differences between July and October, in which the activities in old lagoons were higher than new lagoons. And phosphatase showed differences between old and new lagoons in April and July. If we see this ratio, we see that July showed higher values of peptidase in relation to phosphatase, which probably is because phosphorus tends to accumulate in these lagoons, while nitrogen during confinement is disappears through denitrification, so their community is lacking on nitrogen compounds. That's why they have a higher requirement of nitrogen. Looking through the functional diversity indexes, we only detected differences between seasons. And in this case, the highest functional diversity, meaning more ability to use different carbon substrates, were detected in January and July. And the opposite, the less functional diversity, was detected in October. This was the only month in which differences between old and new lagoons were detected for the NUSE index. This index is related with the uptake of nitrogen compounds in the biolog ecoplates. And in this case, it seems that the differences between old and new lagoons happened between natural and created lagoons, because lagoon G02 was the one created in 2002, and it's acting more similar to the new lagoons than the natural lagoons. With the same data, we also performed an MDS, and in this case, with the results of all the months, we see that the differences occur between October and the rest of the months. So we separated this graph into two different graphs. And in the first one, that contains January, April, and July data, we only observe differences between April and the other 2 months, which are the ones that showed higher Shannon index of the functional diversity. And observing only the October data, we see that this is the only month in which the lagoons get separated into two different groups, one with the natural lagoons and another one with the created lagoons. And here also appears the lagoon created in 2002. The last graph that I will show you is this one, and it contains all the data that we collected from these lagoons. So both the physicochemical characteristics and also the biological parameters that we measured. In this case, we also see that the main differences occurring in these lagoons happen because of the seasons and not changes between old and new lagoons were detected. We see January, July, April, and October, but no differences between old and new lagoons, and also not a gradient between old natural lagoons, this lagoon created in 2002, and the new lagoons. As a main discussion, as I have already said, the main differences detected were due to seasonality, and we detected an increase in enzyme activities from July to October, and this could be related in the first place with the increase of temperature, because it has been seen that enzyme activities depend a lot on the temperature of the environment, but it could also be related with the increase of autochthonous organic matter in these lagoons, since from January to April, an increase of primary production took place, and that could also increase the enzyme activities during these months. There was also seen that the functional diversity of these lagoons was higher in January and in July, and it was lowest in October. It could be related to the entrance of terrestrial material during January and July caused by a flooding episode before the sampling in January, and also a small rains that occurred before the July sampling that could have caused an increase in the terrestrial inputs of organic matter in the lagoons that could have that community adapted to the use of more diverse carbon substrates. While October was more isolated, and then the lagoons, the community of the lagoons would be able only to use those carbon substrates that they used to have, and not that many different inputs. If we check the restoration status, so the differences that we detected between old lagoons and new lagoons, we only detected them in July and October. So when the confinement period was more detected, and it has been more time since the last flooding episode. We can explain the main changes, which are the higher enzyme activities with the higher primary production and also higher vegetation entrance that took place in natural lagoons, in old lagoons, than new lagoons. We also saw differences in phosphatase activity, and that could be related with the higher accumulation of phosphorus that have took place in old lagoons, since they have had more time to accumulate this phosphorus, while the new lagoons only had 1 year to accumulate phosphorus. The main conclusions of this study were that the seasonal variations were the main ones detected. January showed higher allotonous dome entrance along with July, it also showed the highest functional diversity. October was the month where the confinement was more lasting and the lowest functional diversity was detected, but at the same time, the lagoons were more different between each other, so different carbon substrate use was detected. Also in October and July were the months that the differences between old and new lagoons were detected, especially because of higher primary production and higher vegetation entrance occurred in old lagoons than new lagoons. And no differences between them were detected in January, where they were homogenized through the last flooding episode. The gradient that we saw in some of the data between the natural lagoons, the lagoon created in 2002, and the new lagoons created in 2016, allow us to think that maybe time is the only thing that they require to achieve the same status that the natural lagoons have. And also I want to say that functional diversity is a way to measure that restoration status, and if it is done by functional diversity, it should be taken into account the seasonality of the environment that is studied, because if it is affected by seasonality, those changes could affect the functionality of the environment, and it should be taken into account while measuring. And this is all. Thank you for your attention. If there are any questions.
Many thanks, Judit. Are there any questions?
Do I leave the presentation open or do I close it?
You can just leave it open. That's fine. I have a question for you. You mentioned this flooding episode in January. So my question is are those episodes mainly occurring on January, or is it usual that it can happen during the year in winter, for instance? So I understood that you mentioned the specific situation for the study period, right? So are there some differences in other years, for instance?
Yes, since those flooding episodes occur when storms happen, and storms are not predictable, it can happen during all the year, but it's more usual for them to happen during autumn or winter, but it's not something predictable. It can happen on summer also, and that would also homogenize the lagoons.
And could you please briefly explain how you make these ecoplates analysis in the lab? So how does it work?
It's through an inoculation. It already have all the carbon substrates. So you only inoculate the water or whatever that you want to. And then different measures of absorbance were done during 1 week, every 24 hours. And it was detected an increase of the absorbance in some of the wells in which the community used that carbon substrate.
But if I understood it right, so you put water directly from the lagoon, but then I guess you add organic compounds present in the water as well.
Yes.
So so what you detect is the activity of microorganisms degrading the substrates that you put with the community, right? Is
what degrading the substrates that are in the biolog ecoplate.
So you have the organic compounds in the biolog ecoplates.
Yes.
But you add. So when you supplement, so when you inoculate with the water, then you add natural substrates from the natural environment as well.
Okay. Yes, so, I guess the compounds from the biolog are attached to something that produces color, and that's what I detect if they use the substrate from the biolog ecoplate.
Okay. Specifically
those ones.
Biolog ecoplate. Okay. So you expect no interference of natural substrates present in the sample.
No, because there is already also some wells that are controls. So that is taken into account.
Okay. Okay, many thanks. Esther, endavant.
Thank you for the talk, Judit. I am Esther Garcés from the Marine Institute in Barcelona, so I am to the more coastal side of this. So my question is, if there is any mechanism of water exchange from the coastal ocean, because this could be important. So I don't know about the hydraulic component of these lagoons and the coastal water, but this is important because if there is a connection, the water quality of the lagoon could be modified by this entrance, especially in September and when we have these huge temporals as Gloria last year. So I wonder if the biota of the lagoons that colonize these lagoons are affected by these potential changes. That I don't know if you find this.
I didn't check the community, but of course it's affected when there are entrances from seawater during storms. And that affect all the lagoons.
And did you sample in some occasions of these particular moments or particular?
No, we only sampled during.
Yeah, but during all this year that you sampled, did you have the chance? Because there are sporadic, no, and you didn't catch.
Yes, it was only a study for that year.
Okay. Thanks.
Are there more questions or?
Hector he's saying that we are able to review and share this seminar by visiting our YouTube channel, and this is in the chat, so you can watch the video later on. Are there any questions?
Frederic, can I?
Endavant.
Hello, this is Luis Bañeras from the microbiology department or group. I wanted to pose, let's say, a more philosophical question, and I'm wondering if time is a good parameter for comparing the lagoons, because we use time as the I guess the moment the lagoons were created, but they have a completely, they may have a completely different story. So could we think for this type of studies of a parameter or a variable that can be measured in the lagoon that it's independent of time, and just give us the sense of the of how stable they are or how evolved they are? Because I saw in your multiple this multivariable plots that you use that time is sort of diffuse thing there. It's not really an important measure to classify, no, to ordinate the lagoons.
Yes, we saw that sometimes that lagoon created in 2002 was more similar to the natural ones, and sometimes it was more similar to the more recently created ones. So time was not the right measure, and maybe only measuring the functional diversity was enough.
What I mean is that time is something that it's, let's say, anthropogenic. I mean, we create the time, and we started the lagoon, but they have like a different speed in the evolution towards a stable community or a stable functioning of the lagoon, and the time does not consider this. So I think it's sort of connected to what Esther said, that is, depending on the position of the lagoon, you may have different velocities on changing this lagoon, and different speeds on going to a final service or ecosystem service, and the time would not tell you this. I think I don't know if it can be measured anyhow. I'm not sure. I'm not an expert on that, but I was just wondering. And okay, is time really a matter here?
I don't know.
I mean, why all lagoons are old and new lagoons are new? It's just because they were formed earlier.
From before, yes.
Okay. Thank you very much. Very nice presentation. Congratulations.
Come on, Anna.
Just one comment following Luis and Cacho idea, that probably is some relation, there is some relation with the frequency of storming episodes, the frequency of disturbances or something like this a little bit, no? Well, I don't know, because when we were looking at the results and we the first, it seems that everything was the same in all lagoons, but when we look at the results from October, and then it seems that connectivity was important because all were like disconnected, and then each lagoon showed its own behavior, and then some more closely similar that were the all and the this created in 2002, and then no, they all together, and then this created in 2002 together with the new ones. So the amount of the frequency of periods or the number of periods suffering storms could be a factor. I don't know, just following this idea. I don't know.
More questions? More questions or more comments? Okay, so then thank you very much, Judit, for your nice presentation. And thank you everybody to attend the seminar. And that's it. Okay, so you can watch the video again in the YouTube channel of the Institute of Aquatic Ecology. And I hope to see you in the next seminar in next month. Many thanks to everybody.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Good talk. Congratulations, Judit.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Molt bé, Judit.
Merci.
Tècnicament ha sortit bé, eh? Tu estàs contenta també amb el contingut?